Welcome to my fashion. 안녕하세요. Welcome to my fashion. My name is Shinpei Otani from Japan. So thank you for coming to my fashion. I'm really pleased to be here for the first AWS Summit Info. So I'm a little bit talk about the gaming industry and gaming on AWS in Japan. So some of the information is covered by, from the Japan perspective, that, which is not it's some kind of the globally, but real, it's a real use case in Japan. So hope it can help you. So here's the agenda. I briefly introduction to myself and as well as the gaming industry in Japan. Then I'm going for a typical story on using AWS platform on the mobile gaming market. Then I'm gonna a little bit talk about mobile gaming architecture, typical mobile gaming architecture, which is kind of the best to apply to the every users in Japan. Then I'm going for the use cases, including four use cases actually. So let me introduce myself. I'm Shinpei Otani from Japan. I'm a solution architect since 2011, February. So I've been for a while, like almost 5 years since then. Then I'm becoming the FA manager to managing the entertainment and gaming mobile teams to cover the, all the industry in Japan. And some of the publication, in the, sorry, it's all Japanese, but some of them are the Flex, Air, and from Adobe, and some of the Java standard rulebook or Cassandra for the NoSQL services. So let's go for the for what AWS in Japan overview. Some of them are really familiar with you guys, but some of them not. So let me introduce the Japan overview AWS. So since the Tokyo region launched, which is about 2011 March, we have over 20,000 customers in Japan. So we have the, for example, we have NTT Docomo, which is one of the major carrier in Japan. So using for the voice recognition system and also as well as the data analysis platform internally, which is using the Redshift over the petabytes. So the second one to note is the Nintendo, which I will describe later. So they are using AWS for Miiverse, which is a social networking platform for gaming. The other one I like to note is Cookpad. Cookpad is kind of the web service which is very, very popular in Japan. So they are delivering the kind of the gourmet and kind of the how to cook kind of the videos to as web services to all the end users in Japan. So since the Tokyo region launch, we have tons of the customers in Japan, but also the, so on this session, I like to focus on the gaming customers. Then the, one of the unique in Japan is community driven, which is the we have JAWS UG, we call it, Japan AWS User Group, which started since 2010, so which is before the Tokyo region launch. So I'm the one of the core members since then, and I have been contributing some of them. Since then, we have the over 50 branches in the all of the Japan. So we have tons of the user group communicate each other, the share the knowledge, share the best practice, share the real use cases all over the Japan. Hope strongly hope to Korea team can have some kind of the community so that everyone can join and have some fun with AWS. So one of the examples of the power of the community is the cloud design pattern, which you may already know. So AWS cloud design pattern is a kind of the collection of the solutions or design patterns to using AWS properly or correctly to solve the common frequently seen the design problems. So we have published in Japan the two books. The one is for design guide, which is published by 2 to 3 years ago. The another one is coming to recently, to, it's, which is the implementation guide, how to build very well best practiced cloud design pattern based on the AWS technologies, for which is one of the power of the community. So other one is that book, PDP book, is now in publishing in Korea, maybe 1 to 2 years ago. So you may see the book in the AWS booth, for which is there is a community area. So you might want to see that, for which hope I think it's useful for you. So let's move on to the mobile gaming market in Japan, for which is kind of the I think unique. The first one is revenue-wise, application revenue-wise, I would say. Japan is number one, combining the Google Play and also the iOS app stores. The number one for the Google Play and also the iOS app store for the number two. So combining those two, Japan is the number one index of revenue by AppAny, which is a kind of a consultation firm. So that makes the Japanese people to do this. Like Japanese love mobile gaming so during the commune time, so which is around Tokyo. So we have tons of the people coming from the other prefectures to Tokyo, which are about 45 minutes to 1 hour commune time. So 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. to commune time, they are all playing around the games. And then when they are going home, you know, they have tons of the time for like 1 hour to play around the game, like the 5 p.m. to 6 p.m., which is frequently in Japan. So some people say, oh, it's kind of insane, but it's really a real story in Japan. So what is the typical story for when that kind of the commune time and they have some time to play around the games, especially for mobile gaming? So what is the typical story for the AWS mobile gaming in Japan? So let's assume, so we are a customer-centric company, so let's assume one of you kind of wanted to build a mobile game on AWS. So what we need to for the building the kind of scalable, flexible mobile gaming, so the first one from the what I've learned from Japan market is the fast development for developer side. So the one kind of the unique thing in Japan is they are really like the lightweight gaming, not the heavy type of the gaming, like MMO type of the FPS or some kind of like that. Because of that, they have a certain amount of the limited commune time, like 1 hour. So they are liking kind of the really lightweight game, play just a click buttons or mobile games like that. So they need kind of the very lightweight game. It should be speedy to move around, and it should be connected to everywhere from the mobile. Also, to attract to the Japanese customers, they need to frequently release their game or their features anywhere, anytime. So that comes the result of the fast development as well. So also, even if they have the certain limited commute time, but their traffic is very, very much unexpected, so that sometimes it comes like the steep curve, but sometimes not. We don't have enough experience to unexpected traffic. Also, it comes as a result of the no way to predict how much resources you need to build on such kind of the mobile gaming. So from that leads us to the pain point for infrastructure. I mean, the IT infrastructure hinders you to move faster. So that stops you to move faster. So you guys wanted to focus on mobile development, but even if after the release of the gaming, the much less time after launch due to the adding features, adding the new functions as well to development, also the operational things. So the faster development, faster launch without infrastructure burden is really critical for your success. So that comes as the make it faster delivery with AWS. Much more focus on development, not for the operating and infrastructure burdens. Also, high peak traffic is really covered by AWS if you are using the AWS services. Also, additionally, leverage to the new and innovative technologies for you as an infrastructure services. from the AWS platform is kind of the go to something to as soon as you want. You know, some kind of the new technologies, it's really hard to adapt if you stick with on-premise. But with the AWS, you can easily to adapt the new technologies, like the launch another instance and have some trying experimental things and see some of the differences between two. So that's easy to innovative technology adapted in AWS. So let's for having said that, let's move into the mobile gaming architecture on AWS. Typically in Japan, it's kind of the golden patterns in Japan. So I'll show you a little bit one by one. So what would you need for the kind of the latest building infrastructure for mobile gaming, like the modern type of the gaming? So we have three components I think needed. So one is gaming core application, of course. You need some kind of the real stable and scalable, flexible gaming core applications. So another one is batch job capability to reduce some of the workload from app servers to the batch servers so that you can independently scale up and out for both of the two. Also, for additionally, real-time communication capability, like using some kind of a WebSocket or Speedy to connect to the end user to end users, which is critical for kind of the mobile gaming in modern. So one of the mobile gaming architecture is this, using the very typical architectures in Japan. We call it start simple and also keep it simple. So it's kind of the golden pattern for gaming. They are using the basically Tokyo region. Then they're using multi-AZ for make sure that one of the two availability zones to locate all of the EC2 or RDF. Then they are using the VPC for networking side, also EC2 for app servers, RDF for databases, and also they are using for CloudFront and S3 for the delivering the static contents. Just some of the example is the gaming asset in Japan is huge and increasing data size, so that you need to have some kind of the S3 and CloudFront for that. Static contents workload is kind of the offload from the app servers. Also, Route 53 and Elastic Cache is kind of the additional good one to DNS resolutions. Route 53 is go for that. Also, Elastic Cache for making some of the cache contents before the accessing to the RDF masters. So, having said that, AWS is making it much easier to build that kind of the architecture and operate them. So how would you need for that when scale is needed? I would say just scale up and out. So definitely customers in Japan are using RDF a lot. Then they are scale out to the EC2 or Elastic Cache or RDF read replica for that. Also, to the scale up, they are doing the RDF master for scale up mainly. Because of that, they are kind of avoiding sharing the RDF until absolutely they need it. Because of that, the RDF is up to 32 VP CPU and 244 gigabyte memory for as RS3 XLarge, which is really cool. Customers really tend to avoid until they really need sharing because of the adding some complexity to the application side. So, also, they are operating the MySQL very frequently, and they have so many experiences with that. So that's why they are sticking with the RDF. Also, recently, lots of customers in Japan are trying to DynamoDB, which Nate mentioned before in the sessions. That's a NoSQL services really scalable, really flexible NoSQL service in the cloud. So the another one for mobile gaming is batch job capability to put heavy and non-user related workload from the app servers to job servers. Then we can connect between the two, like SQF or mobile push services or data analysis. So some of the batch job example which I described, so image resizing is one of the frequent thing in Japan. Some of the user data uploaded, like the profile of the, your face, then it should be the resized to the mobile, to the tablet or whatever you have the mobile for. Also push notification and the data analysis, I'll show you later. So the first one is SQF, the simple queue services. The queue service in the cloud, highly available, highly scalable, without any burden. It's fully managed by AWS. Also, really easy to use. You put the data, you put the message to the queue, and somebody take out to the, from the queue, that's all. So that's easy to use. So that SQF makes your application, especially for mobile application and batch servers, loosely coupled between the two. So you can scale independently to app servers and also the batch servers. So another one I've frequently seen in Japan is scalable mobile event notification by AWS, Amazon SNS Mobile Push. The simple notification service is kind of the notification service in the cloud, which is also highly available, scalable, pay only what you use, which is very cost effective in the cloud, and also easy to manage. So so that the customers needs to just subscribe to the topic and somebody send to the topic so everybody knows that. So that kind of the event notification is done by the SNS mobile push. So that having said that, the sending million notification to the to end users is really attractive to the customers, end users. So that you can easily use the Amazon SNS mobile push for that purpose. So also the SNS mobile push is able to deliver the cross mobile platform capability like the iOS, Android, Fire Phone or something like that. Also that makes the simplified your code, like the in the mobile code you don't have to kind of the condition to go for this message to iOS or Android or whatever. So you just want to simplify application code, go just send a message to the SNS, so SNS can handle for you. So another one is data analytics, which is really popular in Japan, so which is done by Amazon Redshift. So Amazon Redshift is data warehouse in the cloud, so really easy to use with SQL capabilities. So you can learn the queries like as SQL, as a developer or a data analyst or wherever you want to, you know, that just a SQL, execute SQL is it's much easier to use than any other components. So also it's up to petabyte scale, for which is very scalable. So you can use it very small and up to the petabyte scale, which is a really good capability for that. For having that gaming analysis is really doable without any heavy investment. Previously, on the on-premise, you have to manage, you have to procurement, do some kind of procurement for the data warehouse, which is very heavy lifting things. But you don't have to anymore with Redshift. You can run the data warehouse instances in a minute, so that which is easier than anything else. Also, the S3 and Redshift integration is really powerful. So you store the every log into the S3, then you can take some of them to into the Redshift so that everyone can easily to execute by SQL. So which is very frequently seen in the gaming data analysis in Japan. Also, recently, like modern gaming application needs to the real-time communication, as you might know. So on that purpose, in Japan, WebSocket is really frequently used for kind of the MMO, massive multiplayer online game type of the gaming. So, but with the, having the WebSocket server, which is highly available, highly scalable, is really tricky for us. Because of the ELB isn't a good fit for the longer time connections. So also the WebSocket is based on TCP, so which is hard for ELB to manage. They can manage some, but to the direct connection between the end users to WebSocket server is sometimes needed for the gaming industry. for what kind of the architecture look like is for there are two components, the API servers and the WebSocket servers. For the API servers, so let's say the one of the end users trying to connect to the ELB and the API servers, to the API servers returns to which one you need to connect to the WebSocket servers for return to the IP address or host name. Then the end users directly connect to the WebSocket servers so that you can have the longer connection as much as you want to a direct connection between the end users to the WebSocket servers is really good for the real-time communications. On that purpose, you need some kind of the data store which is really scalable, and also the really light consistency is really required for that data store. So for that purpose, Amazon DynamoDB is really the good fit for the services. DynamoDB is NoSQL service in the cloud, so highly scalable, highly available, and also high-performance data store in the cloud. So it's really good fit, perfect fit for to store the managing, managing the connection state. So for that WebSocket servers, also it's scalable and its write consistency is really a thumbs up. So those three components are really sometimes I've seen before in Japan market. So let's put it all together, which is really. Kind of the really lots of the component, but it's really easy to manage because of the left one is the game core servers, and also the right one is the kind of the WebSocket and real time communication servers, and also there is the batch servers capabilities. So you might see it's a little bit complex, but it's much easier to build your own for. You can fully leverage our RDS or Elasticache, Redshift or FNM Whitebush for the fully managed service from the AWS. So that's the architecture I've seen a lot of times in Japan. So let's move on to the, we only have 20 minutes. Let's move on to the gaming use case in Japan. So I'll introduce you to the four use cases. So four of them is really unique, I think. So let's move on to the first one. The first one is the Nintendo Miiverse. Miiverse is a kind of the gaming real-time communication service for Wii U or Nintendo 3DS. So they are trying to provide some kind of the communication service between the end users. So end users upload kind of the handwriting memo or how you feel it, or what's the for kind of the group activities going on in the Wii U or Nintendo 3DS between the during the Miiverse is working. Also, they are providing kind of the API for gaming developers to connect Miiverse in the game so that you can send some kind of data or some kind of the how you feeling to from the game to the Miiverse so that. Other friends or your friends can see that kind of the how you feel. So several requirements for Miiverse. The first one is scalable storage for uploading, storing the user data. The second one is highly available and durable databases, for which is really needed for the Miiverse. The third one is really important for them because of the Miiverse is a global application across the regions. Across the global, for flexible network for commuting across the geographically, you know, the located in like mainly Japan, United States, Europe is really some kind of requirements for them. For the system overview and architecture for Miiverse, they choose multi-region architectures based on the multi-AZ for each regions. So they choose three regions. The one is Tokyo regions. The second one is United States, and also the Europe region. Those three are combining together, and also they connect VPN each other across the three regions, for which makes them to operate easily and manage easily. So they consume over 1,000 EC2 instances at launch, and they are increasing and increasing. Also, they use REST API for Wii U and Nintendo 3DS directly from them, so that EC2 or Amazon S3 and CloudFront for static contents, so those requests is handled by the Amazon platform. So some of the kind of the illustrated architecture for them, which is very huge, so they use the Tokyo region and also the United States region, the Wii U regions. So they can connect the VPN connection between the two regions so that they can kind of the fully meshed by the VPN. And also they are kind of the building kind of an overlay network between the regions. So they are using IPsec VPN, also the IP tunnel, and also the OSPF for some kind of the network routing between the three regions. So that makes automated kind of a network, and so that makes much more easy to manage and operate. So as Nate mentioned in the previous session, their traffic should be going to the directly to the closest regions. Also, they are trying to the traffic is living in the closest region as much as possible. Even though they are kind of the MySQL replication between the two regions a little bit, but they are trying to the traffic goes to for let's say the Japanese end users going to the Japan region as much as possible. So some of the key takeaway from the Nintendo Miiverse, the first one is easier and flexible to add capacity with AWS is kind of the game changer for them, especially for C3, M3, and also the enhanced networking capability on the VPC is really a game changer for them. The second one is leverage SDK as much as possible in order to automate everything. So they mentioned about automation makes you focus on what matters most to your valuable things, like in that case, the Miiverse platform as itself. Also, they mentioned about technical support from AWS is critical, like a solution architect, also the enterprise support is kind of the really good help from them. Also, they really wanted to solve issue quickly as possible so that nothing gonna happen in Miiverse platform. So just for your information that we are providing programmable infrastructure with AWS for massively scalable and flexible infrastructure like the Miiverse. So we are providing the various languages and platforms like the iOS, Android, JavaScript, Python, Java, or whatever. And also we are also providing IDE built-in support for Eclipse and Visual Studio that makes easier for developers to making something new. Also my favorite, the command line tools for CLI by Python, and also PowerShell for the Windows servers as well. So the second one that I wanna share with you is browser-based gaming Granny, which is kind of the unique one, I think. So they are providing the browser-based gaming since 2013. They kind of migrated LAMP stack completely to Windows and the IIS on EC2. So that reduced the really significant servers, like 300 to 400 servers to about 100 servers. So why I put that case here is, relatively, the Japanese developers wanted to have kind of a Linux-based LAMP stack platform, but I just want to share with you that we can do for Windows and IIS platform as well, which is the Granny is really a specialist group of the specialists for C#, so that they can leverage Windows platform on EC2. So some of the stats, over 100 Windows server 2012, without any issues. Also MySQL RDF and also Redis on EC2, they use a lot for R3 for that purpose. they can handle over 10,000 requests per second or for the 100 million page view per day. So what the customers, the architecture look like, but it's really simple. Actually, it's kind of the golden pattern for the mobile gaming in Japan. So they are using EC2 windows, but they are also using the auto-scaling group. Also, they use tons of the RDF interface, also Redis, and also they are kind of the doing everything on AWS for continuous integrations, deployment, batch servers, or all of the EC2. Also, they are leveraging some of the ISV partners like New Relic for monitoring the operating and the Sumo Logic for the log analysis. So some of the key takeaway from Granny, they work pretty well on the Windows and the C# on their game. And also they mentioned strongly about RDF is critical differentiator for Granny. So one of the key favorite feature is point-in-time recovery. That lets you to recover from some of the failure to the RDF instances, just point of time. So also they really love the R3 8X Large, really well adapted for that purpose. Also, they are really thinking about just the simple architecture. It works very well in Japan and works very well in Granny. Also, they noted about leverage AWS ISV partners such as New Relic or Sumo Logic to make you free from the heavy lifting things like the operating and monitoring, log analysis, visualization, such kind of thing. So the third one is actually I really wanted to share with you is Gunho Online Game Entertainment, Gunho Online Entertainment. So they have so many experience with the gaming for PC online game, but they are kind of just started to the providing mobile game since like 2012. Then, so they chose AWS for mobile gaming. So because of the faster development, they really need to focus on the development with very few limited people. And they really loved our flexibility on capacity. So their game might be success or might be not. So they can change their capacity as much as you want. So that purpose they chose for the AWS. Also, their main title, Puzzle and Dragons, so one of the biggest titles in Japan mobile gaming since 2012, for which downloaded by 30 million plus users from the since 2012. So they are providing seven of the games. The Puzzle of Dragons is one of the major hit game in Japan. So their architecture is very much similar to our best practice. Like they are using a ton of EC2 instances. They may use the ELB for the iOS and Android. They separately managing the architectures. Also, they are finally sharding to the RDF interface to make scalable MySQL architectures. Also, they are using the Elastic Cache, Memcached for a lot of time for caching. Also, they are doing the data analysis by Redshift, for which is very much our practice. Our best practice applied in that. So some of the key takeaway from Gunho is they mentioned in our event in Japan, so we can accept 30 million users without any need of special treatment. So they are wanted to do the everything they want to, like they are making the application as they previously do that. The same type of the application, but they do is just do regular operations and IT optimization, like some of the EC2 instances or RDF instances. So just do the regular optimization, the operation works very well in that case. Also, one of the game changer for them is enterprise support is critical for their success. So especially for 365 operations and 15 minutes first contact response is something that we provide. But additionally, we provide a monthly usage report for them, also cost optimization proposal to them, for which the Gunho never seen before that IT vendors or cloud vendors to doing that. So Because why we are doing that? Because of that, we are so customer-centric baked in our DNA. So we are proposing to the right architecture for right operations or right cost for them to make sure they can be success in the market. So the first one is about automations. So you might see that lots of the architectures very similar, but some of them are wanted to going further for which is automation everything. So the one of the cases is Bandai Namco Studio. They are providing the mobile game named Drift Spirits. They really wanted to, you know, they don't want to manage EC2 or RDF separately. So they wanted to focus on the development with fewer developers. And also they wanted to easily deploy, not only for the production, also to the testing environment. So that's why they choose for OpsWorks from AWS, which is easy and fully automated deployment by Chef. And so it's easy to use by management console capability. So there are two the game changer for them. The first one is time-based scaling, so reduce the unnecessary compute. Because of that, let's say for you guys wanted to have the 50 servers until 9 a.m. to shut down the 50 servers to the 9 p.m. So that kind of thing you can do easily with time-based scaling. Also, load-based scaling is kind of one of the game changer. Lets you the flexibility for auto-scaling, like let's say 65% CPU utilization within the 5 minutes for say, let's say adding the 5 servers to the app servers or whatever they want to. So they are ultimately focusing on the, really wanted to focus on the development side with very few developers at that time, like 3 to 5 developers for the entire game. So that's why they choose for OpsWorks for automations. So a little bit busy diagram, but it's coming from the public references. It's for mobile gaming architecture. That's kind of the pretty much best practice on our use cases. But they are trying to OpsWorks for all of the components they trying to need it. You know, like the app servers for the upper side, or for key value store they manage by OpsWorks. Also the asynchronous job processing server layer, also the monitoring and the gaming management system, all of the components are automated by the OpsWorks. So that's easily can do for you guys also. So it's almost our time. Let me closing remarks. From what I've learned from the Japanese gaming customers within the few years, so I like to note that for gaming customer in Japan well adapted AWS platform for with the best practice I described before. It's really simple. It's really it's kind of the unique things, but it's really powerful architecture. They can apply it. You know that they can do easily scale out. Also they can do easily scale up, so without any burden. Also, I like to note that the power of the AWS platform makes you move much faster. You know, not only for the AWS services, but also, you know, the kind of the automation capability from the OpsWorks, also the technical support team, so like us, or like the technical support team and the support team is really game changer for the lots of the customer in Japan. So sometimes AWS services are really lots of the services. So somebody needs to advise them to applying the best practice for certain use cases. It's really something needed. I have experienced so much things with the customers. So the last one I just wanted to mention about it is AWS fully managed services like the RDF, Elasticache, SQF, Redshift, DynamoDB as just a few examples, change your way to the adapting the new technologies. For the previously on-premise, you have to manage the servers, storages, something like the network to build or try new things. But so you don't have to with the AWS fully managed services. let's say RDF MySQL 5.5 you are using right now, but you can you also can use for 5.6 to try something new or kind of the try to migrate from the 5.5 to 5.6. Well, some that kind of the story I have seen a lot of times in Japan, which is really good. For we hope to provide that kind of the information or some kind of the fully managed services to you, so that you can much faster to move, or you can easily adapt to the new technology, so that lets you take advantage for the new technologies. For the last one, the start your journey from today. The things that I described before is pretty much you can do it from today. So I hope you enjoy my sessions. Also, I hope that you can have some kind of information feel like very useful to from the Japan team. So thank you very much, and kamsahamnida.